Come on in, let me give you a tour of my motorhome. I'm gonna share all that I love, plus the one thing that I don't like at all. Welcome to the channel, I'm Liz, and I cannot wait to give you a tour of my 2005 Alfa See Ya Founder Motorhome. If you missed it, I did a video last week explaining how I came to find this motorhome. Now, one tip I wanna share, if you are shopping for a used motorhome or even a used travel trailer, be sure to set aside some money. You don't wanna spend all your budget on it because you're gonna wanna do some repairs, renovations, and upgrades. This motorhome did not come with full body paint, so it's definitely a nice upgrade and one of my favorite things. So I don't know if you can see this, but now the Alphas were considered a well-built coach back in the day, and they had a lot of clever design features. So one of them was a super high interior height. The ceiling on my motor coach is 7 feet 6 inches. So that's a lot of space, and that really contributes to feeling open and homey. Another thing that contributes to the openness is how big this slide is. And storage is a big factor if you're full-time RVing like I am. I've been on the road 4 years, so having this whole row of cabinets is very helpful. There's actually 3 TVs in this motorhome, and the sellers replaced all 3 of them with flat screen smart TVs. Well, if you watched last week's video, then you know that having a place for my sit stand desk was really important when I was camper shopping. You may remember I had back surgery a year ago. Actually, one of the things that made my back go out was sitting in an RV chair for 6 hours or more a day working on YouTube videos. So what I do is I work sitting for about 30 minutes and then I work standing for about 30 minutes. I feel like I won the jackpot in having the perfect place for the desk. What used to be here were a couple chairs, so it was just no big deal to swap that out for the desk. And I have windows to look out of, so it's really the perfect home office situation. And I will put a link to this desk in the description. Well, it's great that the driver and passenger seats will turn around. It's good for socializing. If I want to put the TV up, I can sit and watch it here or work on my laptop. Honestly, a lot of times I leave this chair facing forward and I just gaze out the window. Well, you can see there is nice solid surface countertops, so many cabinets, so much storage. I mean, it's unbelievable. I can keep my Costco membership, right? Because I can buy all the paper towels and toilet paper. I have room for all that. There's lots of room for dishes and that kind of thing. I mean, it's just plenty. I feel like I'll never fill it up. There is more storage up here with a couple rows of cabinets. I mean, it is astounding how much space there is. Now, it's not perfect. There are some little things I want to do. There are some issues with the hinges and stuff. It's minor. One of my favorite features is that there is a great place for the trash can. It's actually built in under the countertop. You just put the trash in through the hole. There's an access door outside for you to change the trash, so it's really smart. So it has a convection microwave oven, a regular propane oven, and a propane stovetop. Now, I cooked on that propane stovetop just once, and I just didn't like it. I found it really wimpy, and actually on this one, unsafe. A couple of the burners are really easy to turn on by accident, and I did that my first morning here, and I was like, I'm turning off the propane. If you look at new RVs and new trailers, they're going all electric. You don't get a propane fridge anymore, and you have electric cooktop. So what I have is an induction, and I highly recommend an induction cooktop. You need magnetic pans to work on them, but they actually can boil water faster than gas. This is a 2005 Whirlpool fridge, double door, all electric. Now, if you've been RVing as long as I have, you probably are well aware of the limitations of a propane fridge. They just do not get cold enough. You probably are never going to be happy with how cold your freezer gets. The other thing about a propane freezer is that you will get freezer burn really fast. There's no way you could keep frozen veggies or meat even for as long as a month. But somehow I have found myself to be a collector of office supplies. I just, for whatever reason, I can't have enough of them. And so these drawers, this is my office supply drawer. I'm really pleased that I have lots of room for all my envelopes and pens and my scanner and that kind of thing. You can see these drawers latch. There are some places that I plan on camping next year where I'll be like 30, 40 minutes from a grocery store. And if I'll be there 3-4 weeks at a time, it's great that I have room to just stock up. So here's how much room you have. Everything is accessible. I can get to the kitchen. I can get to the booth. I can cook, open doors, open the fridge. And what about the pantry? Well, there's doors on the side and I can open up the pantry. Okay, the bathroom has 3 parts to it and I am just thrilled with it. If you're a couple, definitely look for a bathroom with a setup like this. The toilet is in its own private compartment. You have a shower and you have the sink out here. So the shower is one of those things that I definitely want to take care of sooner rather than later. It has been caulked and re-caulked, so I think I can just get another insert. Oh my gosh, is that black mold? But no, it's actually soot coming in, or dirt coming in from the wheel well right below. So there's a seal or something there that I need to get fixed or try and fix myself. I love, love, love having a washer and dryer. I just feel like there's been no compromise with this motorhome. This is the best bedroom floor plan and storage that I've ever had. I can walk completely around the bed. I don't have to duck my head. And I have nightstands on both sides and lots of storage. And I can still use the bedroom when the slide is in. How can I fix this? Do I have to replace the rail, or is there a way to paint it? One of my very favorite things is the big front window. I was a little concerned because I was so used to having a big back window, and I thought, well, I'm giving that up. But hey, the front window is even better. It has 63,000 miles on it, which I think is the perfect number for a 2005. I didn't want to have something with too little miles on it because that could cause problems. I mean, engines need to be used. This has a 300 horsepower diesel Caterpillar engine. It can tow 10,000 pounds, so I'm well within that on my Ford F-150. The surprising amount of storage up here in the cab. Every single camper I've had up to now has had roof air conditioning, so there'll be a big vent in the ceiling and then the air conditioning sits on the roof. In the Alfa, I have basement air conditioning. It's a lot quieter and it's a great system. Now, my basement air conditioning also has a heat pump. I highly recommend, if you're shopping for new or used, that you look for at least 2 sources of heat. You want to have that propane furnace. They work great in low temperatures, but also having electric means if you're in a campground, you're using their electric. So look for a heat pump, a fireplace, that sort of thing to save you money. Same thing with hot water. Look for dual hot water so that you can run propane when you're boondocking, but if you are hooked up at a campground, use their electric. Like most motorhomes, there is a tremendous amount of outside storage. One thing that I'll be doing sooner rather than later is replacing all the shocks on the doors, because if I need something, it's really hard to get because several of them are broken like this or just can't be trusted. One reason why this motor coach looks a little more modern is previous owners switched out the old headlights for LEDs. There are plenty of batteries. I can see that the connections probably need to be cleaned. Give me some advice, please, on how I should do that. If I'm boondocking, I have heard from the previous owners that I should be able to go 2 or 3 days on the batteries. Plus, when they go low, I have a 7,500 watt diesel generator. You may be wondering, since I have a 2005, well, what about the 10-year rule? You've probably heard that there are lots of campgrounds out there that will not accept campers that are over 10 years old. Let me assure you, I have not encountered that. I started out with a 14-year-old camper van. I've been making reservations regularly for the last 4 years. People rarely ask how old my camper is. I think that was asked one time when I had the camper van, and when I told them, they said, well, just send a photo. That's all they really want. They want to make sure that you're not duct taped together, so it's really not a problem. So don't let that stop you from buying an older one, as long as it's not an eyesore. Okay, so the one thing that drives me crazy about my motorhome is just how hard it is to unplug my power plug from my surge protector. I am talking 2 and 3 minutes of tugging and pulling with all my might. I'm wearing gloves, I'm using my feet. I have actually bruised my hand. I have actually hurt my back trying to unplug the cord from the surge protector. Unfortunately, my power cord has a port that isn't big enough to leave the surge protector plugged in. Now, I know that this is not an uncommon problem, so I'd love to hear your tips on how to solve this. I did get some dielectrical lube. It's electrical protectant and lube for the prongs. It didn't work. So I appreciate your help with that one because it's a little aggravating. There was a learning curve to driving the motorhome, so I'm going to share what I learned and some tips on making it easy and even fun to drive a motorhome. So be sure to watch the upcoming videos about that, as well as how I hitch the truck up to the motorhome. So I have lots of great content for you coming up. And remember, these are exciting times to push past fear, build confidence, and live amazing.